हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर डीलिंग विद क्लास 11th बायोलॉजी एनिमल किंगडम पार्ट 6। इन दिस वी विल डील विद द नेक्स्ट टू फाइलम, फाइलम एकाइनोडर्मेटा एंड हेमिकॉर्डेटा। सो फाइलम एकाइनोडर्मेटा, दे आर स्पाइनी बॉडीड, सो देयर बॉडी इज कवर्ड विद स्पाइन्स और थॉर्न लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स। सो एकाइनोस मीन्स hedgehog, it is an animal which has thorns on the body, and derm means skin, so thorns on the body, but we must remember that hedgehog is a mammal. So why are they named echinoderms? Because they have thorn like structures on the body. So they are spiny bodied, endoskeleton of calcareous ossicles, so internally they have calcium carbonate made horn-like structures which are called ossicles. They are exclusively marine, so all the members are found in seawater. They have organ system level of organization, so they have systems of organ like digestive system, nervous system. Now the larvae are bilaterally symmetrical, so the larva which is like a tadpole, it is bilaterally symmetrical, it can be cut into two equal halves, but when they become adult they become radially symmetrical, or they can be divided into more than two equal halves. So they have both symmetry in life cycle. They are triploblastic and coelomate. Digestive system is complete with mouth and anus, so there are separate openings. Mouth is found on the ventral side, so ventral means lower side. Anus is found on the dorsal side or upper side. There is a special feature which is found only in this phylum. It is water vascular system. So it is a system of tubes through which water enters the body and is circulated. So it helps in locomotion. Locomotion means movement from one place to another. Capture and transport of food, so they can capture food and transport it inside body, and respiration. Now this system also helps in excretion by diffusion into water. The waste materials are diffused in water. Excretory system is absent, so they do not have kidneys or other excretory organs. The waste material is directly diffused into the water. Sexes are separate, so male and female are separate. Reproduction is sexual, so the gametes fuse. Fertilization is usually external, so fertilization takes place in water outside the body. Development is indirect, so the life cycle involves a larval stage with free swimming larva, so the larva is free swimming, it floats freely in water. Example is Asterius, it is starfish. Echinus, it is sea urchin. Antidon, it is called sea lily, it looks like a flower. Cucumeria, it is sea cucumber. And Ophiura, it is brittle star. When its arm is broken, it regenerates its arm very fast. In this figure we can see the different echinoderms. First is Asterius or starfish, then this is Holothuria or sea cucumber, Echinus or sea urchin, it is cup shaped with this opening, this is the mouth. Antidon, this is Antidon with arms, it looks like a plant. Ophioderma, so this is brittle star. And on one side there is mouth, on the other side there will be anus. So these are some members of echinoderms. They have thorns on the body. Here we can see water vascular system of starfish. So in this we can see there are five arms. Inside the arms these are found. So there is madreporite, this is the opening. Then stone canal, so water enters through the mouth. Then opening is madreporite, stone canal, and then they are different arms. All these are pathways. It is called the ring canal in the center. Then there is radial canal, which moves along the radius. Then there are tube feet. There are bag-like structures called tube feet. All these are filled with water. And tube feet has swollen structures called ampullae. So this whole structure is called a tube feet, and the swollen structures are called ampullae. So water enters these tubes and it carries with it food, gases, and waste material can also be released out through the anus. So this is very helpful for this phylum. Now the next phylum is Hemichordata. So hemi means half. So previously this phylum was considered a subphylum under phylum Chordata because they resembled chordates. They had gills and some other parts, but now they have been moved to a separate phylum. They are marine, so they are found in seawater. They have organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, so they can be cut into two equal halves. They are triploblastic and coelomate. Body is cylindrical, so worm-like body is there. They look like worms. Anterior proboscis, so their head is called proboscis. Then there is a collar or a small neck, and there is a long trunk. Then circulatory system is open type, so they do not have blood vessels. Respiration is by gills because they are found in water. Excretory organ is proboscis gland. So in the head there is a gland which helps in excretion through a pore. Sexes are separate, so male and female are different. Fertilization is external, means inside the water. Development is indirect, so they involve a larval stage. Example are Balanoglossus, and one more member is there, Sacoglossus. So this group involves very less number of species. Here we can see Balanoglossus. So Balanoglossus has a proboscis, then collar and trunk. In the trunk we can see gills. So these are the gills, and this is a thread-like structure which is notochord, support for the body. And this is Sacoglossus. So this is the photograph, head, collar and trunk. So these two members are being shown. Now next is phylum Chordata. This is the last phylum which is the most developed. So they have a rod-like notochord present to support the body. So a rod-like structure is present above the body, that is on the dorsal side. It is called notochord. It is solid and supports the body. Then above the notochord there is another cord which is called nerve cord. It is made up of neurons. It is hollow and it forms the nervous system. Then paired pharyngeal gill slits. So paired slits or openings are found, which are actually gills. They are found in the pharynx region, means below the mouth. So these are the three main properties. Bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic. They are coelomate with organ system level of organization. A post-anal tail. So after the anus there is a extension called tail. Closed circulatory system. So they have blood vessels. Example are reptiles, which involve snakes and lizards, and human beings. There are many more animals, but only two are being given. The detail will be discussed later. Here we can see chordate characters, the main chordate characters. So here first is nerve cord. We can see that uppermost part is the nerve cord. Then below the nerve cord is the solid notochord. And then there are gill slits. They are paired and found in the pharynx. So here there is mouth and then pharynx. So these are gill slits found on the right side, and on the behind also there will be paired slits. Last part is post-anal tail. So a tail is also present. Here we can see comparison of chordates and non-chordates. So Chordata was the last phylum. And from Porifera till Hemichordata, they were non-chordates because they did not have a well-developed notochord. So chordates, notochord is present. Non-chordates, notochord is absent. In chordates, a central nervous system is dorsal, A nervous system is there in the form of nerve cord, which is dorsal or above body, hollow and single. And here central nervous system is ventral. So central nervous system or nerve cord is below the body. It is solid and double. So there is a double thread-like structure. Pharynx perforated by gill slits. So gill slits are found in pharynx, and here gill slits are absent. Heart is ventral. So in chordates, heart is found on the lower side of body, while in non-chordates, heart is dorsal if present. So if heart is present, it is on the upper side of body, and a postanal part or tail is always present. While in non-chordates, a postanal tail is absent. So this is the comparison of chordates and non-chordates. In the next class, we will discuss the details of phylum Chordata. Okay, children? Thanks.